Welcome back to All About That Disney Life. I am Danny B, the girl who is all about that Disney life. We now move on to the next attraction for Animal Kingdom. It's Tough to Be a Bug, and it is located at Discovery Island. So a backstory about this attraction. This is a 9-minute long 3D movie based on the 1998 Disney Pixar movie, A Bug's Life, using theater lighting, 3D filming techniques, audio animatronics, and various special effects. Flick hosts the show and educates the audience on why bugs should be considered friends. It was the first Pixar attraction to open in a Disney park. The attraction opened at Animal Kingdom on April 22nd, 1998, a full 7 months before the actual movie debuted in theaters, and is housed within the theme park's icon, the Tree of Life. A second version of the attraction debuted at the opening of Disney California Adventure on February 8, 2001. That version at Disney California Adventure closed permanently on March 19, 2018, and was replaced by Web Slingers, a Spider-Man adventure. On September 9, 2023, at the Disney fan event Destination D23, it was announced that a new 3D theater attraction based on the 2016 movie Zootopia will be opening at the Tree of Life. I did mention this fact when I talked about my Zootopia movie facts back, what is it? I can't remember. It's too long ago for me to remember. Though not directly confirmed in the announcement, the new attraction is expected to replace It's Tough to Be a Bug at Animal Kingdom. The closing date has yet to be announced. So let's move on to the production of this attraction. About a year before the opening of Animal Kingdom, Disney Imagineers had decided to place a show inside the park's centerpiece, Tree of Life, but struggled to find an acceptable concept. Disney CEO Michael Eisner suggested a tie-in with the upcoming Pixar movie, A Bug's Life, and the creative team developed a story based on the characters from the movie. Visual effects, studio Rhythm and Hughes was brought in to produce the 3D animated portion of the show. Disney special effects teams created the rest of the experience, including animatronic characters, wind, water, and foul smells. So let's move on to the queue. As the queue winds around the tree, visitors can glimpse at the animal carvings on the tree that aren't visible from other vantage points. The underground lobby area features posters of various bug acts from the show, as well as those for all insect parodies of Broadway musicals, such as Beauty and the Bees, West Side Story, Little Shop of Hoppers, and My Fair Lady Bug. The lobby music overture consists of insect renditions of Broadway musical numbers. So the attraction itself. After the theater door closes, an announcer advises the audience not to buzz, sting, pollinate, or chirp during the show. Flick the ant in audio animatronic form emerges from a hole in the theater ceiling and welcomes the audience and tells them to put on their bug eyes, also known as 3D glasses. The show begins with butterflies in formation as curtains flying away. After the title card is presented, Flick appears on screen to present the show's acts. A Mexican red-knee tarantula, referred to as a Chilean rose tarantula in the show, named Chili, makes his appearance. A pair of acorn weevils, along with Weevil Knievel, place a slingshot on the stage and launch acorns from it, triggering hidden air cannons. Chili shoots the first acorn with a quill, but fails to hit the second because Weevil holds on to it, then taunts Chili, who chases after him. Flick presents the second act as a soldier termite who defends his mound by spraying intruders with acid. A piece of the set falls with a rumble and the termite-ator steps out, then shoots at a taunting flea, then the audience, sensing more intruders, which triggers hidden water sprayers, despite Flick's protests, until he runs out of acid and leaves, saying that he will be back. Flick reappears and hopes the audience isn't allergic to acid. The next act Flick introduces is a stink bug named Claire de Rume, who walks onto the stage. The acorn weevils place a flower as a target. The weevil re-enters the scene and crashes into the flower, causing it to move towards the audience. Claire then passes gas, which affects and disgusts both Weevil and the audience, which triggers hidden smell cannons in the theater. An explosion is heard, and an audio animatronic form of Hopper, the grasshopper, appears. He orders a stage beetle to chase Flick off the stage, and four wasps hold up an advertisement flyer for Knock 'em Dead Exterminators. The wasps turn over the ad and use it as a makeshift movie screen to show movie clips from old monster movies featuring giant bugs such as Earth versus the Spider, Beginning of the End, and Empire of the Ants. Hopper wants to make humans experience the same medicine, and a giant fly swatter attempts to flatten the audience. After Hopper discovers the audience is still alive, he declares war on them. The screen goes black as a hand appears with a can of bug spray and sprays it at the guests, which triggers a hidden fog machine above the screen. Hornets sting the audience, which triggers a small piece of rubber tubing that pokes each guest's back, and several black widowed spiders go up and down, trying to capture and scare the audience. Now on screen, Hopper boasts nothing can stop him, but a chameleon appears and tries to eat him, making Hopper flee. Flick reappears and says that he forgot to mention the reptiles not caring that it's tough to be a bug, which segues into the finale. Bees, dung beetles, also known as the Dung Brothers, dragonflies, and other bugs sing about how insects help humans and about how it's tough to be a bug. Weevil returns holding a moldy cupcake and the bugs chase him. The butterflies come back to form a curtain, and Flick reappears in audio animatronic form from the ceiling to wrap the show. After the theater is lit up again, the announcer requests the guests to remain seated so the beetles, maggots, and cockroaches may exit safely. The bugs start to talk all at once as they leave, which triggers hidden rubber wheels to roll at the bottom of the seats. The announcer then tells the audience to gather their belongings and take their small grubs by their grubby little hands as they exit. So the cast for the attraction, we have Dave Foley as Flick, Andrew Stanton as Hopper, Cheech Marin as Chili, French Stewart as the Termite Aider, Tom Kenny as the Dung Beetle Brothers, and Jason Alexander as Weevil Knievel. So let's move on to the music for the attraction. The attraction's title theme song was written by George Wilkins and Kevin Rafferty and is included in the disc Theme Park Classics of the Disney Classics compilation box set. The show score was composed and conducted by Bruce Broughton, while much of the cue music was arranged by Wilkins. The cue features parodies or renditions of songs from famous Broadway shows using bug sounds. The first song is called One from a Cockroach Line. It's a parody of One from a Chorus Line. The second one is called Beauty and the Beast from Beauty and the Beast. It's a parody of Beauty and the Beast from Beauty and the Beast. The third one is called Tomorrow from Auntie, and it's a parody of Tomorrow from Annie. The fourth one is called I Feel Pretty from West Side Story. It's a parody of I Feel Pretty from West Side Story. The fifth one is called Hello Dung Lovers from The Dung and I. It's a parody of Hello Young Lovers from The King and I. And the final one is called Tonight from West Side Story. It's a parody of Tonight from West Side Story, and it's mixed with Flight of the Bumblebee. So my experience with this attraction, I experienced all these special effects. They pretty much freaked me out, but I did enjoy the attraction. I mean, it was very entertaining. The part I obviously didn't like was the foul smell that got triggered from the cannon. I didn't like the bee stings in the back. It really, like, it poked me really hard. And then when, at the end, when the bugs were leaving the theater and you felt like the rumbling in your seat, like, you could hear, like, all the audience, like, screaming, like, oh my gosh, is it actual bugs? And it just creaked me out for the rest of the day, like, thinking, oh man, I know it's special effects, but that just felt really weird. So those are the facts to It's Tough to Be a Bug. If you like this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. And I hope you have a zippity-doo-dah day. Goodbye.